Assalamu alaikum, dear students, how are you? Today we will discuss another unit of O-Level Physics 5054, that is unit number 27, the nuclear atom. In this unit, we will discuss different terms related with nuclear atom, like that what is nuclear atom, what is the structure of nucleus, what kind of particle exist inside the nucleus. We will discuss different terms related with nuclear atom like atomic mass number, atomic number. Then we will discuss what is meant by nuclide notation, and in the end we will discuss that what is meant by isotopes and their uses in daily life. So let's start this unit with learning outcome B, that is the nuclear atom. Okay, now we will start the unit number 27 by considering learning outcome B, that is how Giger-Marsden alpha particles scattering experiment provides the existence of nuclear atom. There were two scientists, Giger and Marsden, and they performed an experiment to prove the existence of nuclear atom, that is nucleus. Definitely these two scientists worked under the supervision of Rutherford. What they have done, that they have considered alpha particles and they have thrown those alpha particles on thin gold foil, and they have studied their scattering, that when they have thrown the alpha particles on thin gold foil, then after falling these rays or these particles on thin gold foil, they have studied their scattering pattern, and after studying their scattering pattern, they have concluded different results regarding their experiment. So they have considered alpha particles, and definitely alpha particles are positively charged rays, and they have thrown these alpha particles on gold foil, and this was the pattern of the rays being scattered by the gold foil. So under this diagram, I have drawn a single atom of gold foil, and we will explain the scattering of these alpha particles. So these were the alpha particles or alpha rays, and now you can see that when this ray was in the center of the atom, then this will be deflected back. This ray has shown a bit deflection over here, and this ray also has shown bit deflection over here. And these rays were being undeflected, unscattered, or in other words, we can say that these rays were traveling in a straight path. Now, why the alpha particles were being deflected? Already we have studied that like charges repel each other in previous unit. So it means that when alpha particles were deflected, so definitely those alpha particles will definitely strike with any positive particles which comes in their path. So what they have concluded that from this experiment that there exists a small nucleus inside the atom. In other words, the size of the nucleus is very small, and definitely size of the nucleus is less than the size of the atom. And from this diagram, it is also clear that this was a diagram of the atom and this was the nucleus. So size of the nucleus is very small. And how they have concluded this result? Because most of the alpha rays were being unscattered, or they were traveling as it is, as they were thrown. So in this way, they have concluded that there exists a smaller nucleus inside the atom, and the size of the nucleus is smaller than the size of the atom. What was the conclusion number two? That atom has mostly empty spaces. Now, how they have made this conclusion that atom has mostly smaller or empty spaces? Because most of the alpha rays were traveling in a straight path or in a straight line. So definitely, if they are unscattered or they are not changing their path, so definitely it comes to an end for this conclusion that atom has mostly empty spaces. But with positive nucleus. Why positive nucleus is there? Why nucleus is not negative? Because those alpha rays were being deflected, or those alpha rays were moving away from that particular particle. So it means that that particular particle carry positive charge, and like charges always repel each other. They have made the conclusion number three, that there exists a dense nucleus in atom, and definitely this nucleus carry positive charge, and the size of the nucleus is smaller than the size of the atom. And what was the last conclusion? That there exists nuclear atom. And this was the name of our unit as well, the nuclear atom. So these two scientists have performed alpha particle scattering experiment to provide the evidence for the existence of nucleus. And after observing the scattering of alpha rays being thrown on gold foil, what they have concluded? Number one, nucleus is of smaller size, and its size is smaller than the size of the atom. Atom consists of mostly empty spaces, and there exists a smaller nucleus inside the atom which carry positive charge. There exists a dense nucleus in an atom, and the existence of nuclear atom. So I hope so that now you are able to understand the results of Giger-Marsden alpha particles scattering experiment. Now we will move towards learning outcome A and C.